So hello everyone, in this video I am covering the sequences. Sequences are actually the essential part of the grasshopper. These are used in all of the algorithms. Sequences are found in sets, sequences, and there are many kind of sequences like a character sequence, duplicate sequence, Fibonacci range, sequence, series. So I'll be covering some of them. The first one you see here is the range. It takes two inputs. The first one is the domain and second one is the number of steps. So here you can see I have defined the domain from the construct domain, which is found in parameters, not here, maths domain. Here you can use the construct domain. So construct domain, I have used the starting point at 0 and the 17 is the ending point. So our domain is between 0 and 17 and ours steps is 3, so we are reaching to 17 from 0 in 3 steps. So you can see as I am varying the number of steps, you can make the sequence very easily using the range. And our next sequence is series. What we do here, we define our starting point whatever we want, like here is a 12, and the step size that what should be the difference between, you know, the next number and the previous number, and the count, like how much elements do we want in our sequence. So this is how we generate elements through series. And the next one is generating, you know, the random sequence with you know, creating a list of numbers with random numbers. So it takes three input. The first one is a range. It takes from, so here the maximum value will be 42, and the number is like how much numbers do we want. Like I have selected here 20, we want 21 numbers, so it is showing here 20 because the indexing is starting from 0. So we have 21 numbers which are, you know, in the range of 42. And seed is a very important concept. Actually, these random numbers are not perfectly random. These are generated through, you know, the mathematical algorithm. So if you remember the, you know, the seed, like here the seed is 6. So next time if I want to generate the same random numbers, so I can use this seed to get the same random numbers. So seed is actually a way to, you know, kind of confine your data. And the next one is repeat. So in repeat, what we do, we take a number, a particular number, like here the number is 0.269, and you want to make a list with the same element repeated for some numbers. Like I have selected like for 0.269 should be repeated for 15 times, and it is, you can see it is visible here. Let's make it 17. So there are few more ways by which you can generate sequences, like character sequence. You can generate characters and Fibonacci sequence. And let's go to the next thing which is found here. In when you go to the sequence, there are, you know, you can remove elements from a particular index or a particular position. So I'm talking about a random reduce thing. So what does random reduce? Here I have connected random reduce with the repeat list which I have generated. It takes the list and it asks that how many numbers you want to actually reduce. And here there is also a seed number, because, you know, it reduces, it removes the elements randomly. So seed is also here. So, you know, you can see there are the 17 elements, and here is only 16 element because we have reduced one. So this is how you can control the size of a particular sequence.